Yeah, that's right, Maurice. A mutation in the genes known as BRCA1 and 2 put women at much greater risk for breast and ovarian cancer. But men also have breast tissue and carry those genes. Add in a family history of male breast cancer, and a mastectomy could be a lifesaver for the 2,600 men who get breast cancer each year.
Don Kreef is a happy and very active 53-year-old. An avid biker and successful neurosurgeon on Long Island, he's the picture of health, except for a scary family history that comes as a surprise to virtually everyone who hears it.
I have a grandfather with breast cancer, as well as an uncle with breast cancer. My grandfather died of complications of breast cancer.
That family history led Dr. Kreef to get tested for the two main breast cancer genes. Turns out he carries a mutation in BRCA2.
These are not sex-linked genes, so that means that it's not tied into either sex, and it can be inherited through either mom's side or dad's side of the family.
The combination of male family history and gene mutation led Don to make an unusual decision for a man, to have both breasts removed as a preventative measure, what doctors call a bilateral prophylactic mastectomy.
The risk reduction that we see is over 95%, so it really is still a very, very effective way of preventing breast cancer.
Dr. Bush Devereaux says the operation itself is very similar to a mastectomy in a woman, although there is less breast tissue to deal with, and the options are similar, skin or nipple sparing, and in some cases, even reconstruction. What makes breast cancer in men especially deadly, though, is that most men are ashamed to even talk about it, much less go public. So why is Dr. Kreef doing it?
Because I felt I have an obligation to my patients as well as any potential future patients. I'm not overly attached to them, and off they come.
Now, the absolute risk for men with the BRCA mutation is still much smaller than in women, but it also increases the risk of prostate and pancreatic cancer. Don had his surgery yesterday, and I heard from him today telling me he's at home and feeling a little beat up, but that he can't wait to get back on his bike. And by the way, a thank you to the Male Breast Cancer Coalition. They're the folks who helped Don get some of that information and helped us out with this story today. So it's an important
message.
Life and death,
yeah.
Right?
Absolutely.
Seriously.
Absolutely.
Thank you, Dr.
You bet.